Now, value number method for constructing DAGs. Okay, so we have a simple expression here. You can see I equal to I plus 10 allocated into an array. So how you know this can be represented as a DAG? First, if you look, okay, see, we have I equal to I. So two entry of I here in this, right? So as this is DAG, there will be only one I here in the DAG, okay? And here we have I plus 10. So operator here is plus, right? Left operand is I, okay? Left operand is I, right operand is 10. So this node is created, okay? And this value, what is coming out of this node, you know, that need to be assigned again, assigned back to this I. Okay, so this is what we understand from this DAG. Now, if you just represent this, or if you want to store this DAG in form of a data structure, say called array, in form of array data structure, you want to, you know, store it. Because, you know, when program is going to be executed, you need to allocate memory, right? So memory allocation is one part in the runtime environment. So next topic we will have, that is called runtime environment. So in runtime environment, you will find that in the memory space, there you have different segments. Heap is there, there is a stack, and there is other segments. In stack, you have to allocate memory, right? How we allocate memory? So you need to follow you know, some data structure there, okay? So it can be a stack, and that stack can be, you know, maintained in an array. Understand? So this is how. So here we have I, right? So during parsing, this I is basically identifier or ID, right? So in the symbol table, this I is simply treated as ID, okay? So you can see ID, which is just pointing to some entry for I. It can be, you know, in some memory location on the memory, or it can be entered by keyboard in the runtime itself. Okay, so it is just pointing out to what, from wherever the value of I will be provided, because it is an identifier, it must have some value need to be provided, right? So this is there. Then we have a constant number, it is 10, right? We have 10 here. Okay, then we are doing what? We just give index number. So this is first index, this is second index. So in the third part, what we are going to do, we're adding this first index is representing what? This ID, second index number, right? So ID plus number 10, right? So I plus 10. So 1 and 2, right? Fourth index, what we are entering here? We are assigning, there is assignment operator, is assignment, okay? What the right argument will be assigned to the left argument. So left argument is 1, that means ID, and this ID means I, right? And this 3 is giving the result of 1 plus 2. That means, you know, this ID plus 10. No, this means I plus 10. Okay, so this is going to be, you know, stored into I, right? So this is how it happens, you know, how we can maintain a DAG in a data structure like array. Okay, so algorithm search the array for a node M with label operator left child L and right child R. Okay, if there is such a node, return the value member M. Okay, so if there is some identical thing, then you return the value member M. If not created in the array, a new node N will be labeled with the operator left child N, right child R, and return its value. Okay, so this is what we already know. That is the way of developing DAG, right? So here, data structure for searching buckets. Here you have the main array of the data structure for the DAG. So how this index can be maintained? So array of bucket headers indexed by hash value. So this index can be chosen by using hashing. Okay, and then for multiple operators, left operand, right operand, and all these things, it can be used a list element representing node. Understand? So a kind of a linked list kind of configuration can be used, like one node. If you see in the here, e dot node is basically pointing to two different node. How we can maintain it? Because it is again going to be node, right? If they are leaf or some identifier, then it is not a big issue. But as they are node, so we have to use such configuration, right? So this is what.